Hi, I'm Dr. Richika. You can become a father with nil sperm count. So when I tell this, then you feel that, wow, what this lady is saying, is this a truth or is it false? But it is a truth. So all those guys who are listening or you are seeing this video, you can just feel like it's a miracle for you. Because what happens, one fine day, a guy who is young guy, he gets married to a girl. Then maybe after 1 year, they don't conceive. They visit doctors. First, the female is investigated. Then the male is investigated. And when the male is investigated and you have a nil sperm count, then you feel so much worried that first and foremost, you just don't let the report sink in you. You feel like, what, this can't happen to me. So we, first of all, if all those guys were watching this video and they have got nil sperm count, first and foremost, we have to check this nil sperm count 3 times. So 3 times you have to give the sample to us with 72 days apart duration, because one sperm that is found, formed, it is formed 72 days prior. So it is not that you have given the sample today, then again you are giving it after 7 days. Second, the abstinence period has to be between 2 to 5 days when you are ejaculating and giving the sample to us, because many males, they don't know when to give the sample and it is a false positive thing for them. That is, originally, they are not nil sperm count, but they have been diagnosed as being nil sperm count. So these 2-3 things, first and foremost, if you have to follow. Secondly, if still you fall in the category of nil sperm count, you are unfortunate that you are having a nil sperm count, but then also just don't be worried. First and foremost, first thing is that this nil sperm count is not going to affect your sexual things. So the sexual thing is apart. And this nil sperm count is a separate topic. So it doesn't matter that if you are having a nil sperm count, that doesn't mean that you are not going to be sexually active. So then we now will be discussing about the nil sperm count. What is nil sperm count? So we call 2-3 things. One is aspermia. One is azoospermia. In aspermia, there is no semen that is collected outside. And in azoospermia, the semen is there, but it doesn't contain any sperm. So there are nil sperms, and sperms are the thing that we require for making a female pregnant. So now what to do? You have to see people like us. First and foremost, we try to rule out the cause. What is the cause? What is the problem? Why you are having this nil sperm count? In many cases, there are obstructive causes and some are non-obstructive causes. Some causes can be treated medically because we do all your hormonal assays. Some causes can be treated surgically. And still then there are patients with us who can't be treated medically or surgically. Then you have this question in your mind, then how I'm going to become pregnant, how my wife is going to become pregnant, how am I going to become a father, whether my own genes are going to be used or not. In these cases, further we do test and then we ascertain that, okay, now the patient is ready. So we do a FNAC, that is a fine needle aspiration cytology of the testis. In the FNAC, we see what is the report. In FNAC, usually 80% patients have spermatocytes present in it. Spermatocytes or spermatids, what you call. And these spermatocytes are the preliminary stage of a sperm being produced. So then we make your wife pregnant with these spermatocytes. What we do a procedure called TISA, PISA, and we take out these sperms. And this procedure is not very painful. So don't be worried that something is going to hamper it or something is going to be affected or your sexual parts are going to be affected. Just reassure yourself and just relax. In TISA, we put a small, like a very small needle. It's same like you get an injection. We put that in your testicular area. We take out, we retrieve the sperms and then we fertilize your wife's eggs with those sperms. And so the procedure is basically called, we do a ICSI with TISA and then we make embryos and we put it back in your wife. And when the child is delivered, you can check, you can match the DNA, it matches with you. In many patients in whom we don't get anything in TISA, then we do a TZ. In TZ, what we do, we give a cut and then we take out the tissue and we hunt for a sperm in it. In many patients who are not through with TZ also, then there is a technique called micro TZ. It is the latest technique. And it has been very effective in many of the patients. In micro TZ, we are able to get sperms. We have been able to get sperms in patients and patients have become pregnant with micro TZ. So micro TZ is a procedure for patients who have been rejected for TISA, TZ. In micro TZ, you can get very small because we are using a microscope to see it. You have to understand, if you are using a microscope to check your sperms in your testicular tissue, so definitely we are going to have it. So micro TZ is a big boon for all the couples, and usually, like, if 100 patients are coming who have got nil sperm count, out of that 80 to 90%, we are able to do it with their own sperms, so that when they do the DNA of their child, they are satisfied and they are the true fathers of their children. It's not that they are only called father, they are really the true fathers. So just be assured, just relax. If you have got a nil sperm count, please don't panic and see us.